Hi everyone, welcome to Technical RPA. This video we are going to discuss about in most of the interviews how retry mechanism will work. This question may be very important, so most of the interviewers in real-time environment, in RPA, retry is important mechanism as well as framework. You can call retry as a framework or else retry as a mechanism. How retry will work? So what is the condition? So why I need to go for retry? So these are all the questions commonly most of the interviewers will ask. Actually, I am writing the code properly. There is no issues. Suppose I have 10 lakhs records running on it. Once the records has been completed, I have to send email to hundred business owners to the generated report. I have processed 10 lakh records. Once the processing has been completed, I have to send email to my business owner to the or else my clients 100 email IDs. So probably think through that your data processing has been or data manipulation has been completed. But when you are sending emails, some port disconnectivity has been happened and you sent 50 email IDs through your RPA tools, but remaining 50 email IDs has been stuck somewhere or else some outage happened. So how we can handle this situation? So I need to send 100 email IDs for the processed data, but my 50% has been completed, my 50% has been yet to complete. So in that case, I have to maintain the retry logic. So whenever we are talking about retry, it is not simply copying the code and pasting into somewhere else, maybe creating pages. So retry is always reusable. This is a reusable component. So for example, so this 50 email IDs has been not been sent. How we can know this? Probably we are writing the log files. So my log files are showing 50 email IDs has been completed, but 50 email IDs not completed. So when it is 51st, it's showing no log files. So I am creating log file for all the 100 emails of the data, or else I'm appending the logs. So through the log I can identify this data has been not moved to client yet. So now I'm coming to retry. I'm set first initially retry count is 0, so that 51 has not been sent, So I'm managing my retry one. Usually we have to attempt three retries. Retry count is three in real time. So we are not using more than three. Max limit is three, but it is not good practice to moving ahead of three. So first retry, again I am stimulating my trigger for the 51 files. So probably if it is completed, then it will not go to retry second. And one more thing, each and every retries I will give some gap, 30 minutes. See, these 30 minutes bot will loop into that, sometimes 15 minutes. Once 15 minutes has been completed, the retry 2 will start. So it will attempt to complete from 51 to 100 email IDs. If it is not, the retry 3, the same code will run 3 times. That's all. That's the same setup code. Maybe your tool has been AA, BP, UA path, NICE, OpenSpan, Bega. So whatever may be. But here it will work the same code inside the loop 3 times attempts with the proper delays. So probably if it not completed in third time, so it will send an email to technical as well as business peoples. Bot has failed due to technical exception. Or else system exception. So if some system or application exception has been happened, so bot has failed and bot has retried 3 times. This is the message I have to send to people whoever watching this results. So this is the limit of the retry mechanism or retry framework. So once if it is process has been completed within the 3 times, that would be good. If process has been completed within the first time, the retry will not go ahead with retry 2 because already it is completed. So I have to check each and every time. That my goal is I have to send 100 email IDs. If it is completed, I will not go with retry. If it is not completed, then only I am stimulated to the retry mechanism. So usually these retry counts, we will make it as config file. config.xaml or config.txt, whatever may be. So usually in XAML file will help us to moving fast configuration. And one more thing, no need to initialize the same setup variables again. So this is the benefit of so configuration XAML file. But in configuration txt file, you have to reinitialize all your variables within the proper limits, within the page, within the task, within your component. So So this is the main thing we have to consider on it for retry mechanism. So one more question we can discuss on it. In RPA, what are all the components we can create? See the component configuration component, retry mechanism components, error handling components, and reusable script VB and VBA script components. So these type of components we can create and we can use it across the RPA. So you can easily drag and drop that components, then we can easily use on it. Thanks guys, thanks for watching this video. Probably we can learn some new things in our next video.